Chris Menard here. Part of my online Excel training class is covering the subtotal function when using filters in Excel. Let's dive into this right now. So on the worksheet I'm currently working on called SUBTOTAL Function, here's my data. Just to scroll down and quickly show you, it stops in row 36. What we're going to do is filter by state, but then we have these purchases to date in column H, and I want to average them, total them, and also find out the highest and lowest value. The issue is the normal Excel functions will not work here because we're going to filter the data. So either Control Shift L or go to the Data tab and click on Filter. Let's keep this simple. Let's just go with California to begin with. Click OK. There are my records. Notice the rows are 5, 6, 14, 24, 25, and 28 in this example. Now, the data stopped in row 36. That's why you see row 37, 38. I'm going to simply go down to cell 40 and put in the average. Now, if I do the average function and highlight these numbers up above and press enter, I get the answer 1005. That is actually incorrect. The correct answer, if I just simply select them, and I'm looking down at the status bar, is 1337. So the issue is this. When I did the average function, H5 through H28, it picked up those hidden rows in between. So what you actually want to use, I'm going to delete that function, is the subtotal function in Excel. And I'm going to just type this, SOBT, hit the tab key, or just double click it. What function do you want to use? I'm trying to figure out the average, so that's going to be the number one. Double click, or put in the one, comma. We're on the second argument of the subtotal function. What is it you want to subtotal using one, the average? You pick up your entire range, including what is hidden. My header row is row one, so that is going to be H2 colon, and that's why I pointed out our data stopped in row 36. Pick up H36, press enter, and there's that 1,337, the same answer we had in our status bar. Let's do another one. I don't know what the highest value is. Equals SUBT, tab, what function are you looking for? Max, that's the number four, comma, what is your range? It's H2 to H36. This one's pretty obvious. I see 3,200 and I get 3,200. I always get this question. Someone says, why did the average give you the dollar sign and the highest didn't? I guess that's how they got it programmed at Microsoft. It does this every time. Quick fix. If you like the dollar sign, click on the 1337. I'm going to go to the Home tab, click on the Format Painter, click on the 3200. And that's fixed. Here's a cool tip for you. I want to know what's the lowest. I just did the subtotal function using max. I'm going to do on the keyboard Control and the double quotes or the key to the left of Enter. It copies what is directly above it, but it doesn't change the cell reference. So it's exactly H2 to H36. And I'm going to go in here and click on the 4. Oops, sorry about that. I'm going to click on the 4. Now the question is, well, what function is this to find the lowest? You could backspace and it'll show it to you, but here's a cool trick. Let's go ahead and do the backspace, and it's showing it to you there. But if I still have the 4, and I promise you this, if it's not showing you this, it's Alt down arrow key will pull this back up. So I need to use the number 5. Perfect. I should get the number 250 looking up above, and I do. And again, Format Painter if you want to fix that. And then finally, I'd like to know what's the total of this. Same steps, Control, quotes, get rid of the 5. Here you go. Alt down arrow key. I want to total this up. That is going to be the number 9 for sum. Perfect. Let's go ahead and fix this. Format Painter. All correct. Now, the reason you pick up the entire range is 1, so the answers are correct, but 2, I'm looking at California right now, but I decided I don't want to see California. I'm going to swap states and let's go with Georgia and click OK. And your subtotal function updates. And trust me, all of those are correct right there. That is the subtotal function inside of filters. I am Chris Menard. I hope you enjoyed this. Thank you for your time. Feel free to subscribe. Sign up for my Excel training class. Appreciate it.